My name is Gary Hansen. I'm here at Salt City Steam Fest, and I'm here with Kato. Kato is very well known in the steampunk community. Probably everybody who's watching this already knows who she is. I am unfortunately very uneducated, so I'm going to ask Kato some questions. So Kato, tell me what you do and why you do it.
Well, I am a fashion designer. I run a steampunk clothing company called Steampunk Couture. I've been running for about 8 years now, it's quite old. And I also run a neo-Victorian fashion erotica site called Steam Girl.
Okay, bet that's pretty popular.
It's quite popular, yes.
All right, so how did you first kind of get into it? What kind of attracted you to the steampunk scene?
Like a lot of crafters and steampunks, it kind of found me. I started off in fashion illustration. I wanted to be an illustrator, but I moved into fashion design, and I was kind of very heavily influenced by Victorian style fashion aesthetics and post-apocalyptic stuff. I was a big fan of the Mad Max movies when they first came out. So I kind of meshed the two. I was combining the two and still doing a lot of illustration. And this is kind of back in the MySpace days. So I was releasing a lot of my work on MySpace, my illustrations and some of the new pieces I was making. And then a friend of mine emailed me one day and she said, you know, that's steampunk, what you're doing. That looks really steampunk. And I was like, thanks, okay. Quick, Google steampunk. What's steampunk? And it fit my style perfectly. It was really nice to finally have a name to what I was doing. And so it kind of found me. And I emigrated to the States. And the same year that I did that, I launched Steampunk Couture, my clothing company.
That's excellent. That's really awesome, just to kind of find your niche, kind of doing what you like already.
Yeah.
So you were saying that you had influences from Mad Max and stuff and a lot of Victorian. Do you have like a favorite Victorian story or kind of world? I don't know, a lot of people get influence from books and stuff, so is there kind of a favorite story you have?
I grew up on a lot of BBC period dramas.
Okay.
You know, most of them are really quite historically accurate, and so I got a lot of influence from that. But I also grew up in a 300-year-old rectory behind a cemetery.
Oh.
And my parents embraced the Victorian style because we had this lovely old Victorian house.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I think it was Georgian. I don't think it was even older than that. But anyway, the interior design was all Victorian, and they were collecting a lot of antiques. So that was kind of the norm for me, and that really heavily influenced my fascination with it.
Excellent. Can you give us a description of what you're dressed as today? I mean, being a fashion illustration, I'm sure there's kind of some thought process going into
it. I wanted to go with something kind of cartoony and action hero today. I invented this. This was my aviator hat, but I thought, I think my head's going to be too warm if it's like an entire cap, because it's fleece material. So I just kind of turned it into kind of a headband with the little ear bits. So that's my new piece. And I made everything but the boots.
Okay.
Hand-dyed the pants. Made all my accessories. And my jacket here. And I've got my kilt inspector badge. This was actually a gift from a fan.
Nice.
But yeah. So I just kind of wanted to go with something that really stood out and showed off all the work I'd been doing on my abs.
Yeah. Well, it looks great, obviously.
Thank you.
I mean, do you have, let's see. So obviously, you're fairly well known. Everybody kind of follows your work. Well, I know that that's kind of a different subject, but so how do you feel like all the attention and the fame has kind of changed maybe your work or your attitude towards the kind of work that you do?
It's very weird. Very strange. I kind of got thrust into this. It wasn't like I didn't want to become this well-known person online.
Yeah.
It just sort of happened. And I'm quite kind of introverted at heart. So this is a lot of work for me. It's been great having this big following, this big fan base that it's generated over the years. It's opened a lot of doors and some great possibilities. There's a lot of fantastic companies that have contacted me about creating merchandise and stuff. I have my own action figure now.
That's amazing.
Among a few other things. I don't know, I kind of feel awkward talking about it, but no, it's been great. It's been really, really beneficial. There's the downside too of having a large following, because of course the more people that are following you, the more likely you are to have a large number of morons that follow you and leave you lots of hate mail. But I just ignore that. I just sort of, you know, as long as I don't even acknowledge it, I'm not validating any of those people, and I'm able to keep going and feeling inspired and keep plowing forward.
So do you have any big plans for your work going forward? Any new projects you're working on that you're excited about that you'd like to share?
Well, I'm doing more conventions now. I was so immersed in my business for the last 8 years, I didn't really have the time to go to many conventions. As of this year, I started to get hired to make appearances at different steampunk events and things. So I'm really into that right now, and it's doing a lot for my confidence, which is wonderful. I'm being like thrown onto these panels and got to talk about myself for an hour. But yeah, I have Steamposium coming up in September. That's the end of September in Seattle. And we've just been upgraded from a booth to an entire room. So we have the Steam Girl room, and I'll be inviting a lot of my models up, and I'm being flown up a day early so that I can sort of style the entire room Victorian, with Victorian aesthetics, lots of drapery and antique furniture.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. Thank you so much for taking the time to have an interview with us. It's been really great getting to know you. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Any little punch-ins or anything that you'd like to say to the community?
Well, I'd love for people to check out steamgirl.com. I've been working very, very hard on it, and I'd love to hear what people think, and just kind of turn more people onto it.
Thank you so much.